Hi, it's Carrie. In today's 5-Minute Friday, I'm going to show you how you might go about looking for previously published systematic reviews on your topic. So, ideally, before you jump into a systematic review, you are going to look for other reviews on your topic just to see that it hasn't been done recently or that it hasn't been done before. Now, there are lots of ways to do this. I'm going to show you three ways: PubMed, Google Scholar, and Prospero. And the reason I wanted to do this video is because in published systematic review methods, I'm seeing a lot of questionable ways that people are noting that they're doing this. They're looking in obsolete or no longer maintained platforms or databases, or they're just not doing it at all, and that's not okay. So let's at least look at some ways that you can do this before you get started. I'm going to start in PubMed, and I wanted to show you there is a search filter from the National Library of Medicine. It's for systematic reviews, so it looks for certain systematic review criteria like title words and journals and publication types. Now, it's no longer being maintained, but it does capture new articles. So if we go back to PubMed, the way to enable this filter is to type systematic and SB for the field tag, which is the subset. So we can do that. Additionally, you could also enable this filter by going over here to the left, looking at article type, and choosing the article type systematic review. That's the same filter. So these are systematic reviews that meet that search criteria. We're seeing things as recently as April 2022. It is currently April 2022. So we're going to enter some of our search terms. Let's say we were interested in baclofen pump therapy, baclofen pump, and cerebral palsy. We see three results. So in December 2021, someone did a systematic review on this, along with other interventions, it looks like, and a couple others. So they'd be worth looking at to see if they had done sort of the same topic that I plan to do. We might make our search just a little bit more broad by taking out that word pump. Right, and then we see 17 results that look at baclofen and cerebral palsy. So you can look at the published articles and see if you still want to continue. The next one is Google Scholar. So we're over here, Google Scholar, and we're just going to type systematic review in quotes because it's a phrase, and we'll just do cerebral and baclofen. Doesn't matter what order we go in. Let's see what happens. So we can see there's about 4,600 results. Systematic review is showing up. We're also seeing the word baclofen. We can limit over here by the date range or sort by date. We can choose a date range, so I'll choose since 2018. That gives us 1,850 results, and again, we can see if there's something there that might be too close to our topic. The third way is Prospero. So Prospero is a platform that people are supposed to use to register the protocols for their systematic, rapid, and umbrella reviews. The problem is there's not enough reliable uptake to this platform, so some people are doing it and some people are not. It's still a good idea to check, though. So in order to do that, we'll go over here to search in the top right-hand corner. We can look for baclofen, and we see about 58 records found for baclofen. We'll see the review status over here on the right, so review ongoing, review completed, and published, review ongoing. Sometimes you'll see review completed, unpublished. Let's look at one of the review published. So we'll click on the record, and here we can see the name of the review, the authors, the information from their protocol. If we scroll down, we should see the contact information and ideally a link to the published record in PubMed or another platform. So this is the article that came from that work. You also might click on a review ongoing just to see who's involved, what their protocol looks like, and what their timeline is. So down here at the bottom, you should see an anticipated or actual start date and an anticipated completion date. Those are three ways that you can look for systematic reviews on a topic before you decide to do your own. We did PubMed with a systematic subset. We did Google Scholar, and we looked in Prospero. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.